It's time to shine the floodlights on the para and the disability game. We're going across the UK, visiting clubs to find the unsung heroes of the game, from the grassroots level right up to the elite teams.
And I'm sure we're going to have a laugh along the way. This is Para Football Adventures.
It is amazing to see amputee football taking off in Scotland. Now, amputee football is a form of disability football closest to my heart because I used to play a little bit before I got fatter. So I am looking forward to today.
He hasn't stopped talking about it, so I'm excited to see if you are actually good or not. Should we get in?
Yeah, of course.
Come on,
then. I mean, I'm not.
Could you have made it?
Could I have made it?
Yeah.
Absolutely not. First up, we met Ashley Reid, who helped set up the Amputee Football Association of Scotland.
What we want to do is provide, ultimately, a safe and fun environment for amputees to get together and feel like they're on an equal playing field and play football, but also to give opportunities to play competitively at both local and international level. So we just want to grow the sport. We want to encourage more players to come forward and try it, because there might be people out there who have recently lost a limb and think, I couldn't do that. I couldn't get in a set of crutches and run about. Well, you know, none of these players used to do it either.
After learning more about the association from Ashley, Chelcee and I hit the pitch to check out the rising stars of the game. Keely Soretti, who has been playing for 4 years, and Harris Tinney, who last year became an internet sensation when he shared a video of his footballing skills.
Yes. Completely mesmerised by watching how he uses his prosthetic. I just think it's incredible. The amount of control he's got with that blade is ridiculous. I just want to get one.
It was time for us to kit up and get involved in the action, to find out what it's like to play the game. I was given some crutches and needed some help from Keely on how to use them.
It's so difficult. Oh, sorry. That's me left off.
So, Keely, how did you get into amputee football then? Where did it start?
Started when I was about 6 or 7, and I got through from the Finding Your Feet charity.
When you first got into it, did you find it difficult or?
Yeah, I failed quite a lot of times, but I got back up and I tried and
never give up.
Harris, how did you get into amputee football?
First, didn't really know about it until my mum told me. And then I wasn't very sure on it because I couldn't actually kick the ball with my left foot. But now I really enjoy it.
You said about you couldn't kick the ball with your left. Like me, you're right-footed, even though you don't have a right foot. How hard was it to start learning to do it on your left?
My dad had already told me that I need to start practising with my left because I kept snapping my blades.
How many legs have you been through?
Too many.
So what would you say to other kids out there who want to get into amputee football?
It is quite hard at the start, but as long as you keep trying, you'll get better and better at it.
After being inspired by both Keely and Harris, it was time for Alex and I to team up and go head-to-head against them. Coach Kev was on hand to ref the game and keep a tab on the score.
Right, guys, now we've had a little taster of what it's like to play, we're going to put our two finest against you guys. To make it even, we're going to have Keely playing our prosthetic.
Amputee football is played 7-a-side with unlimited substitutions. The game is played in 2 25-minute halves and there's no offside rule.
Alex, you're leaving me!
We really want to win this, don't we? Outfield players are above or below the knee amputees and must play on crutches at international level.
You are rubbish, Chelcee. There's nothing inspirational about being rubbish. Kick the ball.
Whilst goalkeepers are single-arm amputees.
Yes! To each, next goal's a winner.
Players are not allowed to strike the ball or any other player with their crutches, and slide tackles are not allowed.
Great finish.
No, well done. Listen, thanks very much. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks so much for having us, guys. Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks for megging me on telly as well.
Yeah,
sorry. Really appreciate that. I know what you're laughing at.
I can't believe that Harris megged me in the first 30 seconds of that game.
I mean, they did put us to shame, but that was really shameful. What a good day though, I loved it. Can't wait for the next one.
It was absolutely brilliant. And if you want to find out more about disability football, go to bt.com/homenations or use the hashtag #DiscoverDisabilityFootball.
That's all from us in Scotland, so we'll see you next time.
On the next episode, we head to Northern Ireland to learn about power chair football. Chelcee and I meet some of the elite team and discover it's a lot harder to play than it looks.